What's up, everybody? LQ here. So Father's Day wasn't that long ago. For Father's Day, I had the opportunity to speak in a church environment, and so this was a religious Christian context speaking that I was doing. It was for Father's Day, and I wanted to read it to you, read to you what I wrote and what I said when I was speaking. So here we go. This is a Father's Day message that I gave to a group of Christians. So, Pastor asked me to do a dramatic reading for Father's Day. But as I thought about what character I wanted to play for this reading, things started to change. I started thinking a lot about my own dad. My dad is still going strong. He lives in Saint Paris, where he enjoys being a grandfather to eight grandkids. He is a retired truck driver, and before that, he retired from a factory. He taught me a lot. Through his example, I got to see what a man in a loving marriage looks like, one who honors his wife and guides the family. I got to see what hard work looks like, supporting your family even when it's difficult. My dad passed a lot of these values to me, including my love of the Chicago Cubs, which has become a mostly painful family tradition. He taught me to be nice to others, but to be strong and stand up for yourself. He taught me how to go fishing, and that fishing isn't about catching fish, it's about just being out there. Right now, he's teaching me that when I'm in my 70s, it'll be perfectly appropriate to discuss the state of our country at every single family gathering. My dad has taught me a lot. As I thought about my dad, I realized something interesting. My dad has changed a lot over the years. When I was little, my dad was Superman. He was infallible. I knew, as a matter of scientific fact, that he was the greatest dad in the world. It would not have surprised me to see him leap a tall building in a single bound or defeat a train in a foot race. One thing that all my friends knew was that he could beat up their dad. Then I got a little older. And when I got older, my dad changed. He became Mr. Handyman. I noticed that he was always working around the house. He always had a project. Sometimes my projects became his projects. Pinewood Derby races became personal duels fought by gladiator dads in the arena of PVC. He would fix broken toys, repair appliances. No matter the problem, I knew that my handyman dad could fix it. Then I got a little older, and my dad changed again. He became my buddy. He took me fishing. Took me to baseball games, the Chicago Cubs. I can't tell you how many Cubs games we went to. So much fun. We went to movies. We would spend hours playing Super Mario Brothers and The Legend of Zelda on the NES. We were best pals. It was wonderful. Then I got a little older. I entered my teenage years, and my dad changed again. Only this time, well, I don't know how to say it. But my dad became completely clueless. How was it possible that I was a teenager and I knew more about everything than him? I was simply astonished at how clueless this man was. I even began to question whether or not he had ever been my age at all. Maybe he was simply programmed to be a dad, and he just simply poofed into existence at the same time that I did. Then I moved into my late teens and my early 20s, and dad changed again. Now, don't get me wrong, he was still clueless about a lot of things, but he became really smart about life things. He knew things like how to buy a car, how to manage money, how to rent an apartment, how to buy a house, and how to fix things when life decides not to cooperate. Then I became a dad. And when I became a dad, my dad changed again. I realized that he was there to guide me. He had my best interest at heart. He was never too busy to listen. Sometimes he'd tell me if something wasn't in my best interest, and sometimes I needed a hard lesson to put me on the right track. When I became a father, the way I saw my dad changed so much. I understood that his love for me knows no boundaries. I understood that even in the hardest times of my life, he was hurting more than I was. As a father, I've also understood my relationship with Christ more. Being a father has helped me understand God more. And it's not an accident that Christians refer to God as Father. There's obvious parallels. God's love for us knows no boundaries. He's never too busy to listen. He knows what's best for us, and because of that, he may not always give us what we want when we want it. Like fathers, God's love for us is sacrificial and unconditional. I've realized that my dad's love for me never really changed. My dad is not the one that changed. From my perspective, he changed with the seasons of my life. But he was the constant. I was the one who was changing. In God's wisdom, he uses our earthly relationships to teach us about him. God never changes. We simply learn more about him during the different seasons of life. We change. We grow. The love of God is constant, just like the love of a father. Being a father is the greatest joy in my life. The Lord has blessed me with three children that he's put into my care. My love for them knows no boundaries. I'll always listen to them. I'll always want what's best for them. And because of that love that I have for them, I know God better. So happy Father's Day to all the dads. The Bible's pretty clear that a father's primary duty is to make sure his kids know Jesus. A father shows his kids the correct path by walking it first. A father can be a superman, a handyman, a buddy, and even a little clueless. But I believe a father is, more than anything, an embodiment of Christ's love. So keep loving those kids in your life, dads. Through that love, you will come to know Christ better. Well, I just wanted to share that with you guys. Being a father, obviously, is a big part of who I am. This channel is called IMLQ. I talk about the things that are important to me. That includes comic books and movies and track and field, cross country, family, the trips I take with my wife and I try to include all that into this channel. It is me, IMLQ. But a big part of who I am is being a dad and being a Christian. So I thought that maybe I'd just give you guys a little window into my life for a minute as far as who I am beyond that other stuff, the movies and everything else. So, feel free to comment, dads, on what being a father means to you. Hopefully in this one, we don't get any nasty comments. We might, but being a dad and being a Christian are both very important to me, and just wanted to give you guys a little insight into who I am beyond the movies. So, thanks, guys.